Mayhem is designed to eliminate the noise and provide you with actionable information on real vulnerabilities, better stress test and QA your app, and help your team move faster. I'm David Brumley, CEO of Mayhem Security. In this demo, I'll be covering how Mayhem helps solve three common security and quality challenges. First, managing the supply chain risks of open source and third-party components. Second, checking your code developed in-house. And third, securing your APIs. The demo uses a GPS car tracking app, which consists of three main services. A UI for viewing the car GPS route, which fetches information from a remote API, and on-car code that uploads its position information to the API. The on-car code is written in C, the API is written in Python, and the UI is written in JavaScript. And all three use open source software. Let's dive in, looking at the supply chain first. All of our customers want to understand the risk introduced by their software supply chain. They typically start with a generic static software bill of materials called an SBOM that includes vulnerability information called an SCA report. Let's create a typical static SBOM using Docker Scout for the API server. The static SBOM lists 35 different vulnerabilities found in 19 different packages. But a developer reviewing this list would likely discard most of the results. Why? Well, developers prioritize both security and stability. We've all seen updates break things, so rapidly updating on every new third-party code change is risky. But real vulnerabilities need to be updated immediately. So developers spend an enormous amount of time scrolling through SBOMs to decide what's actually on the attack surface and what can be safely ignored. Mayhem Dynamic SBOM solves this problem by automatically identifying which parts of the SBOM are on the attack surface. First, Mayhem monitors your app as it runs to create an attack surface profile. Then with the single command, Mayhem generates an SBOM showing you exactly what's vulnerable on your attack surface. It turns out, of the 35 vulnerabilities reported by Docker Scout, only three were observed in packages at runtime, with 32 being unobserved. Let's look at the results in the UI. So with a single toggle of a switch, you can look at the full SBOM list and the more accurate, actionable results from Mayhem. For example, while Docker Scout SBOM tells you to update all these different packages, apt, core utils, xbat, GCC, and so on, none of them are on the attack surface. With this single flip of the switch, you can see the one package you need to update to genuinely improve security, and that's Redis. So overall, Mayhem eliminates the work your team spends tracking down useless SBOM results. It gives your team an accurate picture of the real risk, and it focuses them on the actions that will genuinely improve security. Next, let's look at securing new code developers write in-house. The one thing all customers want is secure, bulletproof code. Sometimes customers have tried static analysis, but the problem is that static analysis is false positives because it cannot reason about how your code will actually execute. Mayhem for Code is different because it uses an advanced AI that can actually predict how different code paths will execute and uses that information to find and prove vulnerabilities. Let's look at Mayhem analyzing the on-car C code. So I've added here a vulnerability that can only be triggered by special GPS coordinates. Normally, developers only check happy paths because writing tests takes a lot of time. As a result, testing misses bugs and vulnerabilities on tricky paths like this one. I'm going to ask Mayhem to analyze the app with the Mayhem run command. Cool. So underneath the hood, Mayhem's technology is doing three steps. First, it identifies which code hasn't been tested, thus may have vulnerabilities. Second, it reasons about how to execute that untested code. Third, it creates the test and runs the code and evaluates whether everything was okay or a latent vulnerability was discovered. Let's switch over to the UI. All right. Each time Mayhem unlocks new code, you'll see an uptick in this graph. And if the code is vulnerable, it will diagnose the underlying root cause and generate a test, proof of vulnerability exploit, that proves the problem is real. let's switch over to a finished run because this will take a bit of time. So here we have a real vulnerability where Mayhem has found a buffer overflow. Mayhem shows you the test case right here and how to reproduce this on your own system. It also shows you the line number and the full calling context that help you better diagnose the problem and get it patched quicker. Mayhem also provides you a CWE number and a severity rating based upon a statistical comparison of your bug with previously known bugs. Mayhem does a bit more too. If we go to the exploitability factors screen, we'll see Mayhem has looked at the defenses already enabled in your code. So there were two mitigations here in place, ASLR and DEP, and two more that you can add to further harden your code against exploit weaponization. Let's see those proof of vulnerability exploit test cases and why Mayhem has zero false positives. So I'm going to do this in two steps. First step, I'm going to download the results. And then the second step, I'm going to run the GPS command on one of those results. So let's download it first. And then when it ran this GPS uploader command run, you can see that the actual vulnerability was triggered. That's why we call these proof of concept exploits. So Mayhem also provides value to developers beyond security by increasing the quality and coverage of testing. If we come here and look at the test screen, Mayhem automatically created 74 new tests and increased coverage to 87%. Now, our customers integrate Mayhem typically into their regression test on each new code change. In order to make testing pipelines as fast as possible, Mayhem also optimizes the test suite here from a total of 83 to test all the code covered down to 62 with no loss in fidelity. That optimization means pipelines run 25% faster. Let's look at the code coverage Mayhem produced in the IDE. So Mayhem produces an LCOV file, which you can use in any IDE, and here I'll just turn it on, showing you which lines were tested. So the value is clear. Mayhem automates security testing and stress testing creation. It eliminates the noise because it produces a proof of vulnerability exploit, so your team can have confidence it's focused on real issues. Finally, let's talk about APIs. Just like code, APIs need to be bulletproof and secure. Mayhem for API checks your API for vulnerabilities and also makes sure that it matches the spec you gave end users. Having an API spec that matches your API is crucial for consumers because it ensures seamless integration, accurate expectation, and reduces the risk of errors. Let's run Mayhem here against our API. So here we're specifying the API to run, and we're going to specify to run it for 30 seconds and against localhost. While Mayhem for Code explores execution paths, Mayhem for API explores API endpoint combinations. It does three things as well. First, it checks for vulnerabilities in the endpoint. Second, it checks that the endpoint matches the specification you give downstream users and apps. Third, it checks that it can trigger both positive responses and negative responses. Why? Well, if you only see errors from an API but never a success, then either the endpoint is broken or the spec is off. Either way, developers should take a look. One visual is if you come over here and look at Mayhem for API and the results, you can see that it's stress testing it by trying different endpoints, inserting new behaviors, and deleting things to see if it can trigger problems. If we come back over here and we look at the Mayhem UI for the API, you can see all the problems that Mayhem found. So if we look at these, we can see that it found SQL injection, authentication bypass, patch reversal, and so on. Mayhem for API checks for all the OWASP top 10 problems, so you'll always know that you had a complete check. So if you click on a defect, Mayhem gives you a one-click curl command that shows you how to reproduce it. Let's try this here. Let's just go over to the command line here and Since the run is done, we'll just try this curl command here to see what happens. And you can see here that the system broke. In fact, if we do it this way, it makes it a little bit more nice where you can see that there was this traceback that was encountered by the app. So finally, we built Mayhem for API also to do performance testing. So you can identify things like bottlenecks. For example, here we have three endpoints in the demo app: info, location, and locations. And you can see this locations endpoint took 29 milliseconds in the P50, while info took 5 milliseconds. That's about 5 times slower than other endpoints, suggesting a potential place for improving the API. So in summary, Mayhem for API identifies publicly exposed vulnerabilities, flags spec issues that could impact API consumers, and helps shift API performance testing left into your pipeline. Finally, let's talk about how you can integrate Mayhem into your environment. Mayhem can be deployed as a SaaS, private cloud, or even on a completely closed network. Mayhem comes with integrations into CI/CD systems like GitHub, GitLab, and others, ticketing systems like Jira, and can export its results into standard posture management formats like Serif. Mayhem also comes with integrations into most enterprise identity and authorization services. So that's Mayhem. If there's one thing you should take away, it's Mayhem eliminates the noise and provides you with actionable information on security and quality.